The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Kevin in Orlando. Hey, Kevin, what's going on?
Hey, I'm doing great. You know, I am addicted to TFNN.
We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here. It's a great network, man. And I want to thank everyone out there, you know, for making it a great network.
Well, it's great because I do outside sales, so I get to have the station on my phone the whole day. And when I go pick up the kids at from school at 3 o'clock, they all love and give them the old ram. Educating the kids at a young age is a good thing.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever. You focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. The start to a better life or a better world or a better future is simply our belief that it is possible. Unknown author. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 66, NASDAQ's down 17, S&Ps are off 6.5, gold contract up $8.70, trading at $1,239 an ounce, silver up 5 cents at $16.95 an ounce, platinum up $3 at $1,013 an ounce, copper flat at $2.25 a pound, light sweet crude down $1 at $42.76 a barrel, bonds, you have the 10-year note, down 3 ticks, 129.11. 30-year bond off 17 at 161.30. King dollar down 305 ticks, trading at 94.77. The yen is up 4 ticks at $1.12. And the euro is up at 4 ticks at $1.12. And the yen is trading, that's pretty cool, actually. And the yen is trading down 60 ticks at $1.11. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in y'all world. The world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. Where are we at? Okay, so we're going to look at this on a weekly basis. What we did last week is that we got into 2104. That's the December 2nd swing high. We did that twice. It failed twice. Failed on volume. First day on the daily. Second day had volume. Third day it tested. It failed again. On the weekly, you failed on price and on volume. Okay, so we made it to the 2111 last week. You're at 2,085.82 now. Your next step down here looks to me about 2,052. It's going to be interesting when we get into that level. We are definitely going to need. Now, what we have out here today is really this is just a sideways market. You get light volume. It's 539 million. So you get a sideways market going, and you have light volume going. A lot of numbers are going to be coming out after the close today, tomorrow, the next day. Bottom line, what I do expect is you're going to see lower prices. Why? Because let's go over to the SPY for a second and the Qs. When we came down Friday, folks, we gapped. Well, we didn't necessarily gap. You did a slight gap, but you had an explosion of volume come out of the market. On the SPYs, we had hit a high on Wednesday with 81 million shares. We come down with 99 million shares. You go over to the Qs. What do we do with the Qs? Bottom line, we had volume come out of the Qs on Friday of 39 million. That's after basically trying to get into highs with all of 17, 25, and 21 million. Today, light volume, sideways move. The Qs looked at this particular point that the next space that they want to go to were at 105.72. The March 10th high out here is the next place that these babies look like they want to go to, which is a 105.86. Now, what'll take them down there? Well, it's going to be pretty wild watching this thing shake out. So, Apple. Apple's going to be the biggest mover, I suspect, inside the queues. Apple is coming out with their numbers after the close tomorrow, on the 26th. Facebook is coming out after the close on the 27th. So you can see that's some good action that we're going to have inside these markets. Let's go over and we take a look at the gold contract. So what do we have with gold? Gold contract, excuse me, folks, trading up $8.60. You got 114,000 contracts traded. What we did last Thursday is that we got up to the 1272, monster volume up there, had the wide price spread, had the accelerated volume. That's saying that gold still is building cars to get up into 1287.80. We've been, you know, basically building the same type of cars since February 11th. The equities themselves have gone much higher, but the contract itself is still building cars to get up into that area. Notes, what do we have at the note market? And by the way, we have a Fed two-day meeting that starts tomorrow. The notes, 10-year notes down four ticks. We're trading right now at 129.11. This is baby's making its way down to the 129.02 to 128.01 level. And now King Dollar. What do we have with King Dollar? So King Dollar, folks, last week had a small counter trend bounce. We bounced up to, there she is, okay. So Friday, we got up to the $95.18. We're at 94.78 right now. King Dollar is still building cars to get down into this 92.50 area. 92.50 area, folks, is where the August 24th swing low is. That's one price projection. What we also have is that we have another price projection of the 92.30. 92.30 is a confirmed ABC structure on the way down. So your probability is pretty high that we're going to run down into those areas. The Fed meeting that starts tomorrow goes to Wednesday. It is a two-day meeting. More than likely, we're going to have nothing happen. In the futures market, there's a 0% chance. Now, when I say the futures market, the Fed futures, how basically people are trading on this, 0% chance on the 27th that we're going to have one. Right now, this is how the numbers shake out for future rate hikes, okay? This is the buying and selling of the futures as to where the market thinks the Fed is going to raise. Tomorrow, rather, the 27th, zero. June 15th, 23%. July 27th, 34%. September 21st, 48%. It doesn't get over 50% until November 2nd. So it's going to be wild watching this whole thing shake out. Now, keep this in mind. These change every day, okay, because the market changes every day. If we had looked at these, which we did before the last meeting, these were not only all much higher, they were all over 50% starting in June. You know, bottom line now, market's saying that, guess what? I don't think we're going up in rates. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Let's go take a look at some of the higher volume stocks, and this is a low volume market out here today. We have Advanced Micro down to 48 cents. The stock is getting killed, man. PRGO, that's down, looks like it's down 19%. It's down $20, and do not touch this thing, man. So this gave it away on Friday. Friday was breaking swing points with volume. What it done Friday, Thursday it was trading at $128. Friday it broke to $120. Expansion of volume, and then guess what? Today just blown it right apart, man. This thing's going a lot lower. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials right now are down 74. NASDAQ's off 20. S&Ps are off 9. We're going to be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a two-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your two-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, two times currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is down 73. NASDAQ's off 20. S&Ps are off 9.5. And as we do each and every Monday at 20 past the first hour, we have our man, Mr. Steve Rhodes. Now, don't forget, folks, every trading day right here at TFNN, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, we do live programming from 8 o'clock in the morning to 5 in the afternoon. Tuesday, Thursday, 7 o'clock in the morning to 6 in the afternoon. Get everything right on your cell phone, TFNN.com. Just hit Tiger TV. Every trading day, 1 to 2 Eastern Standard Time. Steve's got a great show. If you're in your car right now, East Coast, West Coast, remember, just go to TFNN.com, hit Tiger TV, get a great program. You also got a great newsletter, the Mastering Probability. Now, you can come over to our website at TFNN, test drive it 30 days, absolutely free. You go to newsletters, trading newsletters, you see Mastering Probability right there. Steve Rhodes, what's going on?
Well, is today a holiday that we don't know about?
I don't know, maybe. Every day is a holiday we're alive and kicking, I guess.
Today, you know, if you take a look at the queues today, just as an example. So right now we're at 11.4 million shares.
Okay.
The lowest trading volume of the year, 2016, thus far, took place on March 28th. On March 28th, it did just shy of 14 million shares.
Okay.
Today could end up being even slightly lower than that. It's going to be somewhere right around there.
Right. I see a point. Right. The holiday. You know,
Because, you know, typically you would, you know, you'd anticipate that on a, you know, a day after Thanksgiving, something like that. And, but today doesn't even, so really interesting that, you know, the trading volume today, you know, what's its message? You know, the Qs, my studies show the Qs typically make highs on low volume. Now, obviously, we're off of that high, just really a tad from a couple of last week on April 19th out there. And hey, you were right. I heard you say that when you were going to the ETFs that they had gapped away. The Qs, and this is where, you know, perhaps there is really a subtle message here. The Qs on Friday, when they did gap down, what they really created out there was that island reversal top. So, Tom, if you take a look at the Qs had gapped up from the April 12th trading session.
Oh, yeah, I can see that. Okay,
right?
Cool.
They gapped up just like, and the high of that trading session was, the price point on that was 109.72. And the lowest low that occurred during that 4-2-4-6 trading sessions never got down to touch that level. Got down to maybe 109.88, so it missed it by by several pennies out there. And then that gap away created that island top. Now, I anticipated that we'd see, you know, most traders would see that out there. And it's in the NDX 100 as well. You had volume that was accelerating, you know, to the downside on Friday, 39 million shares out there. But, you know, today, just a sideways move. I had thought that maybe it was because of Apple's earnings. Last week, on Monday, when we looked at it, it was a lightish volume day too, but Apple's the one that had the most volume to the downside out here. So, and Tom, the last time that the Qs had a island top was the trading sessions of December 29th and December 30th. And that's where the island formed. And then on that very next trading day, December 31st, when nobody was looking, it gapped down to the downside. And then, you know, that's where we went ahead and moved down into the February bottom out here. So, you know, you can't neglect the island top that's out there. That's for sure.
Yeah, and of course, tomorrow night after the close is Apple. And that's going to be the NDX period, so...
Yeah, and that's still, what, about 11, 12% waiting inside?
It was 11.34 last Friday, so.
Yeah. Now, what's interesting, though, about Apple, when I take a look at its chart out here, is, and it didn't create an island or anything, but, you know, it had some pretty decent volume for this equity as of late. March 29th, 31 million shares to the upside, and a little gap away back on March 15th, 40 million shares to the upside. And today, you know, traders aren't really sure what to do.
No, only 22 that's for million sure. Shares. Exactly. Yeah.
So, now, but here's what Apple could do, right? So, it's not until tomorrow afternoon when they're going to, right after the bell,
yes.
When they're going to, or 4:30, right? I think they usually do theirs right on the half hour. And, well, what Apple could actually do out here, this would be a trip, is they could be creating their own island.
Yeah, it's a nice one, too. I know.
Yeah, that could be one that really takes folks.
So are you looking at the 15th of March, right?
From the 15th of March. Yeah, yeah.
And if that's the case, folks, okay, the larger the island, the more destruction. And that would be quite a – that'd be pretty intense.
Certainly, Tom, it certainly brings into play that August 24th bottom out there.
Right.
You know, with 162 million shares. And you'd have to just anticipate, you know, that is likely where this equity would travel to. You know, it's not, it's in fact, it, I'd argue that if it really did create that island and it started to, you know, will it take 162 million shares? That's going to be tough to break through, don't you think?
The first time down, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know,
if it does, you know, it's headed to seven in the 70s.
Oh, yeah. No, I think Apple's going to 79. That's January 31st. So,
yeah. Yeah, they got to come up.
Sticking
they
out
come,
like a sore thumb right now.
Yeah, they got to really come up with some great next deal, whatever that is, you know, inside this equity. It'd be nice if we get Apple down to so that it's not the heaviest weighting inside the NDX 100.
Yeah, it's getting there. You know, it's interesting. It is getting there. There's no doubt, man.
Yeah. Yeah. The other thing I'm watching is, you know, it's light sweet crude trading right now at about 42.78, and I think that. You know, there still is this huge correlation, directional correlation between the direction of the stock market, the close of the stock market, the S&P,
yes.
And the close of light sweet crude. And its real significant level of support is right around 41.75 to about the 42.06 area, which happens to line right up with a weekly and a daily TAS market profile. You know, so if it can get below that, then, you know, light and it's interesting because, you know, there's several A to B equals CD patterns out here in light sweet crude. It could take off the other way as well. What do you show as volume today to the down? You know,
it's a lot. It's, you know, and particularly because what happened, folks, is that, you know, this morning this volume wasn't that much, but someone was selling into this in a big way. You know, 2:30, they start pushing into it big time. So it looks to me like, you know, it's going to make a run for that number you talked about. I mean, it's, you know, that's the highs of what, the 18th, right?
Yeah. Yeah, wow. Absolutely. Yeah, you know, so it lines up inside there. Interesting that for the first part of the year, you know, the normal news media was really always talking about the correlation. I haven't really heard that too much inside, but it still is out there.
I mean, it is exactly. That's pretty funny.
It still is out there. So every time I take a look at the markets, I've got to go over and say, okay, what's crude doing out there? So you know, that's something I pay attention to, and pretty decent moves that we've had over the past couple of days in the currency markets too. So what's your take on the U.S. dollar index?
Yeah, you know, to me, that still wants lower price, man. I mean, you know, that baby, you know, it hasn't, you know, really,
sure.
Really wasn't a big bounce last week, but that was not a bad bounce. But this can't get into that 94.67. It just has a hard, tough time. That's 30,000 contracts there. We came into it with 21,000 Friday.
Yeah,
pulling back down, so that's saying it's going to go after the lows. And of course, that'll line up with the Federal Reserve not raising rates again Wednesday.
Yeah, well, we'll look forward to the fireworks show at 4:30 tomorrow when you're calling Apple.
It's a beautiful thing, man. Thank you so much, man. Have a great one. Have a safe one. Don't forget, folks, you get Steve's newsletter right now. Go over to our website at TFNN. Go to newsletters, trading newsletters, Mastering Probability. We're coming right back, folks.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
If you're looking to discover a new financial resource and diversify your financial portfolio, don't miss out on the MarketSafe Commodity Solutions CD from EverBank. This is the second running of their popular 5-year U.S. dollar-denominated CD, which gives you exposure to 8 equally weighted commodities, including WTI crude oil, gold, silver, copper, nickel, soybeans, corn, and sugar. With annual pricing caps of 70% per component, you could earn up to 70% upside payment at maturity if the commodities increase in value across annual pricing dates. And should the opposite occur, your principal is 100% protected. Keep in mind, returns are based on CD performance. There's no annual percentage yield or periodic rate of interest on this indexed CD. Don't miss out. Take advantage of this financial resource designed to grow with the times. The May 19th funding deadline is quickly approaching. So hurry over to everbank.com/TFNN for the CD's term sheet and other important product details and disclosures. Once again, that's everbank.com/TFNN. This advertisement is sponsored content. EverBank is a member FDIC.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. We hit the Dow down 69 right now. NASDAQ's off 22. S&P's are down 9.5. If we go inside the Dow Industrials, we look at the strength versus the weakness. This is what you have. So the strength out here today is McDonald's. That's up $1.75, trading at 127. You got Walmart up about 47 cents, trading at $69. Disney is up 59 cents at 104, and Verizon is up 18 cents, trading at $50.73. Taken away from it on the way down, Caterpillar is down $1.84, $76.48. Visa is down $1.10 at 78. You got Goldman off 191 at 164, and Intel is down 35 at 31.89. Now let's go over and take a look at the energy sector. We'll take a look at that energy sector out here. There we go. I'm sorry. Yeah, we'll go here. Let's go take a. We get Affirm from Dallas, Texas. Hey, Affirm, what's going on? We lost him. We have him? Nope. Okay, so I'm going to do the energy first, and I'll go back. He wanted to look at GILD. So if we take a look at the XLE, XLE right now is trading out at $66.08. And this little baby. Looks, I mean, it still wants to make its way up to this. Oh, interesting, though. Hold it. 1 second. 67. Oh, this is pretty cool. Okay, so check this out. The November 3rd swing high we've been looking at for quite a while. That's on the daily. Well, on the weekly, what we have here on the weekly is this. The weekly, the low of that weekly was 67.52, and we actually hit 67.29 last week. With 94 million versus 84. So, that's saying that, hey, guess what? That can go back up into that area. That's what it looks like it wants to do. Let's go to Afim. Hey, Afim, what's going on?
Hi, Tom. I love your show.
Thank you so
much. I've been listening to you since 2001 from my Seattle days when you were on a little station there.
I appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Thank you.
Yeah, question for you is about Gilead Science.
Yes.
I have a spread for it for May expiration.
Okay.
The earning is coming out on Thursday night after close. What do you think? Where it's going?
Okay, so we're at 102.17. Yeah. I've been careful here. You know, I mean, this looks to me like 97. This is not strong. This has just come up to.
Yeah.
This is just coming up to ice here.
Well, I have a put and a call. The upper price is 102 strike price. The lower is 100 on the put side.
Okay. So you still, I mean,
this thing moves about $5 or $6 after the earning, doesn't it?
You know, it can move that much and more. There's no doubt about that, man. Do you know what I mean?
Well, I'm looking for more.
You know, I think you're going to get. It looks to me, yeah, well, if it goes to 97.63, you get $5.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that's where this little thing looks like it wants to pull back to. I mean, I can even make, yeah, I can make a case that 93.50 is the number two. So 93.50 is, that is the high of January, the week of January 29th. That has some pretty big volume there. It would be hard to break that in the first time down. Let's put it that way.
Yeah. 93.94 would be awesome if
yeah.
it gets there.
That would be a good one for you. And that's coming
yeah.
out, let me see. So on the 28th, yes, that's Wednesday, right? Wednesday after the market's closed. Let's see. No, is that Thursday?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, Wednesday. Yeah, so
okay.
You might have some action there.
Okay, well, that's good to know.
Okay.
I thought I'd give my guru, Tom, call and see what he says.
Yeah, too much, man. Well, listen, thanks for bringing us from Seattle to Dallas, man. Appreciate it.
Yeah, I love all the hosts, and I love your show. It's I'm addicted to it.
It's Hotel California. It's wicked, isn't it, man?
Yeah.
Thanks.
All right, Tom, nice
okay, man.
To you.
Have a great one. Have a safe one. And don't forget, folks, no matter where you are in the country, that's all you need is that cell phone. And if you haven't test drove the TV platform on the cell phone, do it. Because it really, you know what blows my mind, folks, is that it seems that it's even clearer on a cell phone than it is on a TV. You know, if you have an internet TV, do it on an internet TV. It's a mind blower. It's the charts are just fabulous. You know, because it's a visual deal. There's no doubt about that. 877-927-6648. Let's go take a look at the financials. Okay, so we just looked at the energy sector. XLE looks like it could go a little bit higher. You know, that being said, though, that oil contract looks to me like it's going to go lower. We take a look at the XLF. XLF, we went up last week with 239 million shares. You got to $22.63. Yeah, this doesn't have any juice. Okay, and this was going into $323 million. So $323 million versus the $239. We got to, let's see, $2,363. Yeah, this is pretty cool, man. Okay, so, and we closed at $2,355. Okay, so on a weekly chart, folks, the XLF failed on price, failed on volume last week. And when you do that, bottom line, that's normally you get a change of trend. So we'll see how that shakes out. We take a look at Goldman, how Goldman's trading out here. Yeah, this is a dead cat bounce on Goldman's. Goldman had a nice expansion up. There's no doubt about that. Last week, Goldman went from 157, runs up to 168. Now you're at 164. You know, but what it was running into, it was running into the downdraft that had 5.5 million and it got up with 4.1. That's not enough. JP Morgan, so let's take a look at JP Morgan. JP Morgan, also last week we went from a price point of $61 up to 64. You're at 63.59 right now. And, okay, so 62.16 with 37 million. Plus 20. Okay, so JP Morgan on a daily had some pretty good juice. Now we'll flip this to a weekly. And when you flip this to a weekly, first week we went up on 116 million, last week 75 million, not even close. So 75 million was going into 114, 64.66. Okay, so we got over the high of 64.66. We closed at 63.97. So that was a failure also on price and volume last week. This one's a little bit more subtle, but that's a failure on price and volume. So, because we did 75 million going into 114 million going into 147 million. So those financials are saying they also want to get into lower price. The big number, no doubt, when we take a look at these markets out here, oh, you want to see something that really is getting whacked up somewhat, is WYNN, W-Y-N-N. This is down $5 right now, trading at $90.97. And if we take a look at this on a weekly basis, we'll see how this sets up as it's pulling back. Now, as this pulls back, this very well could be an equity that, you know, you may want to be picking up. But get it on your radar, folks, because this came off the low nice. It's an equity that absolutely has got killed. Came off at nice. You get a nice high volume swing high at 102. You're at 90. And, you know, this thing can pull back to like 59 or 60 bucks. If we got a consolidation like that, those casino stocks love trading in monster consolidations. You stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.
John Logan has just announced that he is hosting a workshop Wednesday, April 20th for all TAS Profile Scanner Plus subscribers, opportunities in the current market, and strategies to profit. In this hour-long workshop, John Logan will use the TAS Profile Scanner Plus to give you a current breakdown of the sectors in the market and the opportunities that are present, as well as providing subscribers with the best strategies to trade with to profit when using this powerful piece of market scanning software. Right now, you can sign up for the TAS Profile Scanner Plus at the front page of TFNN.com. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is such an amazing piece of software that we're even offering a no-questions-asked money-back guarantee for all new paying subscribers. Don't delay, as John Logan's subscriber event is coming up soon. Sign up now for the TAS Profile Scanner Plus and be up and running within minutes using this powerful piece of market scanning software. With a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Sign up today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering four-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per a $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These four-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. We have, we got Boeing down 51 cents. You got Caterpillar off $1.77. GE is, that's only down 13 cents. GE's down 13 cents. You got Merck down 57. Big Mac is up 197. Procter & Gamble is up 36. Amazon is up 357. Let's see when Amazon's coming out with numbers. So Amazon, 28th also. Oh, baby. So Wednesday, it's going to be a big number. So Amazon comes out the 28th. Facebook, I think, is the 28th also. Oh, Facebook's the 27th. And Apple's tomorrow. So this is going to be wild watching this shake out. So Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, we got action out here. So if we go over to Amazon, let's take a look at Amazon. So Amazon right now is trading at 623. Put this on a weekly. See how this thing is shaking out. Okay, so the high in Amazon was generated the first week of January. That high was $696. It goes straight down to 474. It goes straight back up to 638. So last week we did 18 million versus 33. Let's say this baby's gonna be back and down. So we're at 623, 581 is game on Amazon. It's going to be wild watching this thing shake out. And that's not even the high volume swing low. Where I'm going with this, folks, is the week of March 18th, you know, it had some volume. But this is an equity that wants lower price. So if we go over to Apple, because we'll take a look at where we think the NDX is going to be by the end of the week. Go to Apple. Apple's at $104.95. On the daily basis, it looks like what's screaming out here is, you know, the 103.75. Now, as Steve and I was talking, this is where it's going to get really intriguing, because there was a small gap from March 14th to March 15th. And if it gaps over that level, and the bottom of that gap is $103.85. You gap over that, then that leaves that whole island up there, which that's a very large island. And that is set up, you know, bottom line, $96 on Apple. And I think you can get there pretty quickly. Facebook. Now, Facebook, you know, bottom line is making money hand over fist. That being said, though, guess what? You know, you have a downdraft that it's coming into. You know, Facebook looks just like Google, actually. Facebook on February 2nd was trading at $117. 5 days later, it's at 97, down 20% in 5 days. Took about 2 months to get back to the highs again. Came back down again, and we came back down with volume. So Facebook is also saying that it wants lower price. We're at 109.81. You get a high volume swing low from 2 weeks ago at 106.52. And then you actually have, if we put this on a weekly, what you're going to see is that, yeah, the 105, it's not going to be the end of the world, but 105 looks like where Facebook wants to get into. So when you look at the, those are three pretty good size weightings inside the NDX 100, and they all look like they want lower price. What's going to be intriguing is that if we look at last week, the big equities that came out in the NDX 100, that is, they had a tough couple days. You had Google go from a price point of $760, that went down the next day to $713. Right now you're at $721. Microsoft went from a price point that had closed at $55.78. Next day it opens down to $50. Starbucks, SBUX. What's going to be intriguing here is that the Starbucks had closed at $60.64. Next day it's down to $57. You know, so the correlation of Apple, Facebook, and not that Facebook, I don't think Facebook's going to get down a lot, but 4 or 5 points. But Apple and Amazon themselves, that baby goes down there with where I suspect they're going to go. You're going to see some big action inside the queues. And the way the queues are set up is that the queues, you're at $108.84. You get light volume today, sideways move, no big deal. But the queues are set up that the first leg down looks like 105.86, where that's 3 points down from where we are. Next leg is somewhere about the 101.83. That is the highs of January 20th. And then if we do lay this out on a weekly basis, you know, what you're going to see down here, it's screaming too, is $98.69. That's the high of the low. The last low that was generated out here was February 12th. That low is $94.84. Now, the cool thing, folks, is this, is that depending on how we get down here, if it's a straight line move down, you get another bounce, you know, because that bounce there. So check out what the queues are doing. You had 350 million on a weekly basis, was testing the 449 million from August, was testing the 424 million from the prior October. You know, if you always, you know, remember that October swing low of 2014, that was waiting to get tested forever. Well, sure enough, it got tested. And when it got tested on high volume. 449 million was testing 424. When we come down in January, it was 350. So you can see what this bounce is all about. And the key on going up or going down is how much energy is taken out of the market before it gets to the price projection. And when you do a straight line move, guess what? Market gets tired. You know, so how we get down to that level will tell us once again, is that level going to hold, or in fact, is that the trading range that's set up? And that's, you know, either way, folks, it's going to be really cool, because if that's a trading range that's set up, it is one monster trading range. And the market has certainly shown at this particular point that it can't take out the highs, you know, because if we go to the, yeah, I'll do the other correlation for you inside the market. And when you take a look at the queues are actually showing that it's really weak, because the high in the queue is $115.75. We couldn't make it up to the gap the last time up. And, you know, you're talking about coming down on a weekly basis of $262 million, $336 million, and we did $136 million. So it's anemic in a big way. So, it, you know, we'll see how we build cause down to get down to the other end. And what I do expect we're going to see, and we're going to get a fast and furious, will be when Apple comes out with the numbers, Facebook comes out with the numbers. Because if Facebook basically can't handle it either, then you're going to see some real destruction very, very quickly. Amazon also. Amazon can take things to the cleaners and take them to the cleaners very quickly. No doubt about that. Let's go over to the good old King Dollar. So King Dollar last week gets a decent bounce. Nothing big, but, you know, it came into a low rejected that low. When we went high on Friday, there were 21,000 contracts. Now we're giving it back on 14,000, which is really light, but it can't get out of a lower zone that it's trading in. You know, so I expect what you're going to see out here probably Wednesday and Thursday is you're going to see another verification that the Fed's not going up on rates and the dollar will get weaker. You know, when we look at the rate structure across the world, our rates are still not just high, they're dramatically high. You know, in Germany, the 10-year is 0.2%. We're 1.9, okay? And that's great for us, but the bottom line is that when you look at a percentage on move on that, that's like, it makes zero sense that they will go up on rates versus just lay out there and hope for the best. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is down 57. Nasdaq's off 18. S&Ps are down 7. And let's see if I get this. This is pretty intense. So Deutsche Bank, folks, you know, has been paying fines hand over fist for a long period of time, man. But this is pretty intense. So Deutsche Bank's board erupts into conflict over its legal expenses. Deutsche Bank's mounting legal costs led to an open conflict of its supervisory board, with the deputy chairman publicly criticizing another member for going too far into probing potential wrongdoing. Now, what's going on here? So check this out. Check how much. This is pretty amazing what they've already paid. This is since 2013. They've paid $13.5 billion, billion with a B. Of course, that wipes out not only profit. It wipes out a lot of the bank's capital ratios. So what's going on here now is this, is that they put a board member on to basically dig into all the problems they have. And when one of the board members saying they're going too far, what's going on now is that they're actually here. So here it is. Toma, who leads the committee that monitors and analyzes the bank's legal risk, has become isolated from other board members, according to two people familiar with the matter. His relationship came under strain after he started to investigate the links between fellow board members and Deutsche Bank's legal proceedings, said one of the people, folks who asked to remain anonymous. Bottom line is that, man, once it's one of those deals. It's why banks and large companies do pay huge fines to get rid of everything. Because guess what? They keep digging, they're going to find it. You know, bottom line is that it's pretty amazing what they actually get away with on a continual basis. Let's go take a look at the volume out here, because it's going to be light volume on this pullback. On the NYSE right now, you're only at $645 million. That's saying it's going to come in about $800 million because you have 4 minutes left. And on the NASDAQ, we're dealing with NASDAQ's dealing with $1.4 billion. And, you know, after, you know, some of the energy that came out of the market on Friday, that's normal. That's how this thing is shaking out. You know, the Dow really hasn't moved much. You know, you're down 46 bucks. This is all a sideways move. What the Dow did do also, though, is that when we take a look at this on a weekly basis, the Dow also failed to hold its swing point of that 17,977. So it would have to get over that 977 in order to basically get in the larger range that it could go after the highs. But thus far, it just hasn't been able to do it. The composite, we take a look at the NASDAQ composite. The composite and the NDX basically are the weaker indices when you take a look at whether it's the Dow, the NASDAQ, on the small caps. And in the composite high is 52.31. We only made it last week to 49.69, you know. So the composite itself has a monster supply line from March of 2015 going all the way over to January of 2016. You know, that's quite a supply line. And that's all distribution at that high. And every time it's up there, they're just pushing out more stock. So numbers are going to move around the markets out here all week long. And of course, then what we have is that we have the Fed meeting starts tomorrow, goes tomorrow into Wednesday, and I don't expect any change out there. As we come into the close out here, the Dow no doubt caught a bid, because the Dow had been down 80. It's only down 38 right now. If we go into the E-minis, we take a look at the E-minis. E-minis are up down $5.50 right now, and they're also the high of the day is 2080 or 2080.50. You know, so we'll see what kind of numbers we have after the close. What that does to the market. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming back with some numbers. Dow Industrials right now down 38. Nasdaq's off 15. S&P's are off 5.5. We're gonna be right back.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Alex in Newton. Hey, Alex, what's going on, brother?
Hi, Tom. How are you doing?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
I'm doing pretty good.
Good, man.
Subscribe for your gold report. I've been following you for a while. The first time I subscribed for it. And what I love about your gold report is that you give us a direction. You give us an overview of the whole market, and you leave final decision to us, because you give a lot of ideas. After that, you can choose whatever you want to follow, whatever you don't.
Yeah.
That is great.
Okay, brother.
Thank you.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one.
Thanks.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Dare to believe. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials down 26, NASDAQ off 10, S&P's down 3, gold contract up $8.40, trading at $1,238 an ounce, silver up 9 cents at $16.99 an ounce, platinum up $5 at $1,014 an ounce, copper flat at $2.25 a pound, light sweet crude down 88 cents, trading at $42.85 a barrel, bonds, we had the 10-year note down 5 ticks, 129.10, 30-year bond off 23 ticks, 161.24, King dollar down 290 ticks, 94.79. The euro is up 39, trading at $1.12, and the yen was down 56, trading at $1.11. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Wanna know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? We look at this cash S&P. What we had last week is that we had a failure on volume and on price on the weekly charts. So we got to 2104, actually 2111 last week. 2104, that's what it was testing. Failed on price, failed on volume. We have out here today, bottom line, you have light volume. We pull this back on a daily basis for a second. What you're going to see is you're going to see a rejection of lower price with light volume. So he did 60 million shares. Friday, you did 99 million. We're at 208.61. That's saying, hey, intraday tomorrow, I suspect you can get into 209.39, somewhere in there. Actually, hold it one second. 207. Yeah, 208. Yeah, you can get into that area. You can get into the lows or the highs. And I do expect that it's not going to get anywhere, but bottom line, right now, we got to lower price. You had lighter volume. You rejected lower price. That's saying get the SPYs could get higher. The Qs are a different ballgame. The NDX 100 went down Friday, monster volume. You went down with 39 million shares. You did sideways today with 14 million. That, to me, is still saying it wants dramatically lower price. I suspect the next move on the NDX 100 or the three Qs would be 105.86. What you're going to have out here tomorrow is that tomorrow night after the close at 4:30, it doesn't say 4:30 now. Well, we'll see when it's going to be out. Bottom line, after the close tomorrow, Apple's coming out with numbers. Apple's trading out here at a price point of a 105.08. That baby looks to me like you're going to have lower price coming at it. So Apple is going to be the mover in the market after the close tomorrow night. Gold contract. What do we have with the gold contract? Gold contract, folks, is building cars for higher price. We did contract value today of 115,000 contracts. The high volume swing high out here is 1287. Right now we're 1238. Last Thursday you ran up to 1272. It failed on price. It got the volume going. It went to 1272, ended up closing that day at 1250. You know, when you get higher price with higher volume, you can back off, but guess what? You go right back topside. Gold has been building cars for quite some time right now, meaning the gold contract since the 11th of February. Silver, what is silver indicating? Silver really gave us some nice information last week, and what it was is this. We got to a price point of $17.72, monster volume, in the silver market. When we got up to that price point, we did 142,000 contracts. Now, out here today, which is pretty cool, is that we went up 9 cents, but we did 61,000 contracts. That also is a decent move inside the silver contract. If we take the silver contract and we put this on a continuous basis, what you're gonna see is this. It took quite some time for the silver contract to get away from the $16 area. Just it kept going up to that level. Sellers were there on a continual basis. Then what ends up happening, it just gets up and over that area. And it looks to me that silver basically wants to run into not just the 1760 area, but 1850 is game on silver. So I suspect what we're going to see out here is that the silver contract more than likely is going to lead the gold contract higher. The oil market, what do we have with oil? Oil right now, folks, we did 600,000 contracts, 591,000 contracts today. Oil right now looks like we're at $42.86. 41.66 is game, 39 is game. So this is going to be intriguing watching this oil contract come into those levels. Because if you get an expansion of volume, which we did today, it's subtle, but, you know, that would basically bring it down to the lowest swing point, which is $39. What that would do inside the oil and oil service stocks, that would bring that to lower price. The note market, what do we have with the 10-year notes? Okay, so we have the Fed meeting, starts tomorrow, goes until Wednesday, 2 o'clock Wednesday, announcement. No press conference, just an announcement of what they're going to do. Bottom line, what I expect you're going to see out here, or maybe there is a press conference, I got to check that out. 129, 10 we're at, 128.01 is the high volume swing low for March 16th. That's where this baby looks like it's heading. And what that's saying to me is that that's saying, guess what? No rate hike this time. In fact, the probability of a rate hike inside the Fed futures market is zero. You know, in June, it's 23% now. That's June 15th. July 27th, it's 34%. September 21st, it's 48%. And then November 2nd, that's when it goes over 50%. It's 52.9%. So bottom line is that the betting inside the market of which way Fed futures are going all the way up to November before there's a 50-50 chance that it wants higher price. King dollar. What do we have with King dollar? King dollar, folks, is still building cars to get into lower price. King dollar out here is trading at a price point of $94.79. You did 14,000 contracts, which is low volume, by the way, as you pull back. But what you have is that King dollar just can't seem to get its bid into a higher price point. So we have two numbers that looks like King dollar is going after. The first one is $92.50. That's the high volume swing low from August 24th. The second one is an ABC structure on the way down. That ABC structure on the way down has a price point of $92.30. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. Stay right there, folks. We'll be coming back with some numbers for you. Dow Industrials closed down 26, NASDAQ off 10, S&P's off 2.5. We're going to break back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls. Now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over to a few numbers that just come out. San Mita closed at $22.21. This is a subcontractor. It's trading at $23.65 right now. Let's take a look at how this is set up. So this is interesting. Okay, so $23.65. This got a high volume swing high at $25.64. Numbers go like this. So the second quarter revenue is $1.6 billion. Earnings per share is 63 cents. So they're seeing third quarter go up slightly. The estimate was 61 cents. They see 61 to 65 now. Let's go to Mike in Boston. Hey, Mike, what's going on?
Hi, Tom. Just quick questions. Thanks for taking my call.
Sure.
One question is, I own Great Panther Silver, and should I keep accumulating or should I just hang tight?
No, you got to hang tight. Okay, so let's take a look at it. You get Great Panther Silver.
Yep.
Great Panther, folks, is trading at 143. This is an equity that has gone from 30 cents to 164. We actually own it at like 41, 42 cents since I started the gold report. So, I like how this is set up right now. Okay, so what this did for our folks is this. It finished an ABC structure on the way up. It went to $1.64. The A to B equals C to D was 153. It did it. It did it with volume. So you get 4.9 million shares. The high was generated last week. Then it backed down with lighter volume. And this is where, folks, when you have gaps in equities, you'd like to see them filled. And we got that filled on Friday. The stock went from 155 to 127, like in a heartbeat. and that's heat if you're buying it up at these levels, right, Mike? You see what I'm saying?
Right. Yeah.
So the way I'm looking at this is that, you know what? I would stay in it. I wouldn't accumulate up here. And, you know, the next run up, they're coming out with their numbers, I think, next week.
On the 4th, yeah, I seen on the 4th or something.
On the 4th, right? And, yeah. You know, we'll see whether this can make that run to 257. See, the next leg right. on this, what you have is this, folks, is that July of 2014, you're at $1.49. Well, this came into it with the kind of volume that you're looking for in order to basically jump that and really get some juice underneath it. We did it with 15 million shares versus 9. So when you do that setup, okay, what you do is you take the high of that 149, you take the low, which was 36 cents, you know, you can say, okay, you add a buck to that, I'm just ballparking, it's 259.
Right.
So that's where I'm staying with this thing, you know, because when you bring this higher, you do have that swing point at 248, which brings you all the way back till September of 2012.
The last question, I know you're busy, but here's a question. Because I've been in the gold and silver up and down, and unfortunately, I rode it all the way up very good, and I rode it all the way down very bad. And that's why I'm saying now that I'm making profit again, I know how fast it turns up and down. It seems that the long run now looks better, almost like the early 09, 10, and 11.
Yeah, I'd agree, but now this is a different question.
Yeah.
Yeah, see, that's a different question altogether, because if you don't sell, then you know what to do? Sell half of it, man. Sell half of it. You got to get used to selling. You know what I mean?
Okay.
That's what you got to do.
Yeah. Okay, I'll put the stop loss in below that a certain price where I feel comfortable, correct?
You can do it that way. Yeah.
Right on. All right, I appreciate it.
Okay, man. Have a great one. Have a safe one. I really should have asked him, I'm hoping that he didn't write it down from 2011. But I've seen plenty of folks that have done that, folks. And the bottom line is that we're in the marketplace to do what? To take money out of the market, not continue to put more money in the market. You got to remember why you're in the marketplace in the first place. Bottom line, this is an extraordinary run. There's no two ways about that. You got to make sure you take your money, because if you go over and take a look at the XAU and the HUI, this is what we're doing, folks. If you're in this metals market, you don't get the gold report, go test drive it for a month. That's what you should definitely do. I mean, that's a no-brainer. It costs you nothing. And say the first month I don't even think you put, I think we take your credit card, but it doesn't even get charged until the following month, because this is what we're doing. We're coming into a huge supply line that was from June of 2013 over from September to 2014. That's the line that we're coming into. Now, there's a few equities that just blew right by that line, which is pretty cool, so that gives you an indication that can happen. That being said, I do expect you're going to have to build some cars to get up and over that line. That's in the XAU, and that is also in the HUI. We're coming, in both cases, we are coming into that, though, at monster volume. So that's the type of supply line that you like to come into. And what supply line means, folks, is that there's a lot of folks that are in the equities. It was a consolidation that was going sideways for a long period of time. So that is supply up there that has to get bought. That's how this shakes out. So we'll see how it works out. But, that's what's happening out here. If you want to go over and we'll take a look at it, I'll show you a Rango Resources. Rango Resources just took it out like nothing. And they took it out quite a while ago, too, by the way. When Rango... this is one of the strongest gold stocks. This went from $54 up to $91. It took a bit to basically take it out, but when this took it out, it just sliced right through it. On three separate weeks, it just blasted right through it. It started at $60. 3 weeks later, it's up at $90, has the volume, it's over that area now. Now what that's doing, that's building cars to get up into its highs, which is 127. And that area, this to me, we've been building cars here now about 9 weeks. And it looks to me that when this takes off, it's gonna go after its highs. And we'll see whether it can take over its highs. Franco-Nevada is the leader. Franco-Nevada, no doubt, not only took over its highs, it has the volume as it took over the highs that we were talking about. Franco-Nevada, $60.07. That swing point had 1.4 million and 3.3 million, and it just took it out with 6.8 million, followed up again with 8.4 million, followed up last week with 5.6 million. So Franco-Nevada, thus far, is giving us the best signal that not only did the metals want higher price, that they will actually get higher price. Because you got to remember something, the Franco-Nevada, how their business plan goes, it's a royalty equity. And what that means specifically is that the higher the price of gold, the more that they make, because it's a percentage of the full price that they get without the expenses. And when you look at their price structure, they have they take in $405 million in revenue on gold, $28 million oil and gas, and $10 million in nickel. So bottom line is it can discount the oil and gas and the nickel. It's all about gold. It's $405 million, and Franco Nevada has all of 26 employees. So that's all about where is the price of gold, period. Dow Industrials closed down 26. NASDAQ was down 10. S&Ps are off 2.5. We're going to be right back.
If you're looking to discover a new financial resource and diversify your financial portfolio, don't miss out on the Market Safe Commodity Solutions CD from EverBank. This is the second running of their popular 5-year U.S. dollar-denominated CD, which gives you exposure to 8 equally weighted commodities, including WTI crude oil, gold, silver, copper, nickel, soybeans, corn, and sugar. With annual pricing caps of 70% per component, you could earn up to 70% upside payment at maturity if the commodities increase in value across annual pricing dates. And should the opposite occur, your principal is 100% protected. Keep in mind, returns are based on CD performance. There's no annual percentage yield or periodic rate of interest on this indexed CD. Don't miss out. Take advantage of this financial resource designed to grow with the times. The May 19th funding deadline is quickly approaching. So hurry over to everbank.com/TFNN for the CD's term sheet and other important product details and disclosures. Once again, that's everbank.com/TFNN. This advertisement is sponsored content. EverBank is a member. FDIC.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
It's 2016 and TFNN has a brand new programming lineup to kick things off. Starting January 4th, Swim Lessons by Thinkorswim and TD Ameritrade will be airing 5 days a week at noon Eastern Time. Join hosts Scott Connor, Kevin Hinks, and Cindy Faber as they host their daily options program live at noon 5 days a week with no commercials for the entire hour. Nico DeHaan and Paige Clark will be moving their program, Living a Primal Lifestyle, to twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7 a.m. until 8 a.m. Eastern Time. Wake up with Nico and Paige and start your day off right. The Bull Bear Binary Option Hour by Nadex will now be live Mondays and Fridays at 10 a.m. Start and end the week with the three hosts, Tom O'Brien, Tommy O'Brien, and Daryl Martin, as they break down the world of trading binary options and spreads. For all the details on the new 2016 programming lineup, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go inside the commodity market for a second out here. So natural gas. So let's see. Today's oil numbers come out Wednesday, natural gas Thursday. Natural gas was down 3.2% today. Crude was off 1.9. Wheat was up 0.7%. You had soybeans up 1.3. Corn was up 1.6. Cattle was up 1.7. Now, let's go over to the fertilizer stocks. So this is going to get really interesting watching how these are shaking out. Now, these equities, folks, got absolutely smoked, okay? We look at Mosaic first. Mosaic is trading at $28.24. The low for the year is $22. The high is $47. You take a look at this. I'm going to bring this back on a longer basis so you can just see the toasting and roasting that these stocks have actually got. If I take this on a 10-year, what you're going to see is that it's hard to believe I can go back to 2008. So 2008, Mosaic's trading $159. The crash, it goes straight down, $159 down to $21. From that point on, what does it do? Then you have a consolidation In 2011, it gets up to 89. Okay, now, that being said, so check out what this did. The last time that we came down, which was this January, we got to $22. We did that on a monthly with 131 million shares, and guess what? That was testing the high volume swing low from 2008. So watch this. 2008 high volume swing low is $23, 480 million. The following month, you got to a lower low at 194 million. Now, the 194 was testing the 480. Well, it rejected it. What does it do then? You went from $21, and 2 years later, you're at $90, $89. Okay, so keep that one in mind. Now watch. We came down on 131 million into $22. Well, the 131 million was testing the 194. So on a monthly basis, you have a nice test that's in place. Now let's go to the weekly. And that's a long-term test, by the way. So now we go to a weekly basis. And what do we have? When you take a look at the weekly basis, and we bring this closer in, it's like, okay. On a weekly basis, this looks to me like $31 is kind of game that I suspect the stock wants to go to. Don't buy this thing right yet, but because I think what we have here is this. You're going to have a $10 consolidation, which is just great for a $20 stock. So we came off the lows of $22 in January. You got up to 31. We did 31 with 35 million shares traded on the weekly. Then what do? We pull back with 21. So you can see we pull back with 30% lighter volume. You go higher again last week, and we did 27 million. So you had an expansion of volume, not the 31, but you had the expansion of volume. Okay, so now watch. Now let's put this just on a daily. On a daily basis, what you have is that you're down 27 cents today, and this baby can come back to $25. Yeah, I'm going to do Potash too, okay? And this is the reason I'm going to do a few of these, folks, and this is why. This is how the sector is set up. So on Mosaic, I suspect you can get back to about 24.91. If you do that with light volume, that's going to be a buy. And that would go along with the aspect that these grains want to go to higher price, that in the commodity market in general, you're going to have higher price. If we go over to Potash, we take a look at it. I went through a bunch of these earlier today, not on the air, but off the air. And they're set up just about the same, but they're really set up cool too, okay? Meaning, I think they want higher price. The consolidations are pretty big. Like in Potash, the consolidation is from $14 up to $19.38. So we put this on a weekly basis. What you're going to see on a weekly basis here, well, first I'll put it on a monthly so you can see what a disaster it is. This disaster went from $80 down to $15. That was in 08. Then did a counter trend bounce to 63. Now watch how this shook out too. We hit a low of $14.64 in January. We did 225 million, and that was coming into 757 million. 225, 757. You can see that correlation. That's a nice correlation. Okay, now get into a daily, and what you're going to see in the daily is this. The top of this consolidation still has some pretty good juice. 1938, and these are absolutely not buys right now, but I suspect what you're going to see here also is that Potash will pull back down to the 1581 area. If you do that with light volume, it's going to be a nice setup. Why? Because the January, that's on a daily, the January low is 1464. The high of that low is 1581. You put your stop on the other side of 1464. You're at 1581, and guess what? You're gunning for the top of that consolidation, which is 1938. You know, so we'll see where that whole thing shakes out, but it looks to me at this particular point that that's game. And of course, it's going to be King Dollar. Keep your eye on King Dollar. King Dollar wants lower price. If we do go over to some of the commodity, let's go to the wheat market for a second, because this is pretty cool. I like how this has been shaken out. Wheat, where are you? Okay, so wheat is trading at 477. This is a market that went topside last week in an incredible way, gave it up in an incredible way. Okay, so the futures market went from 453 That was the 11th of April. It gets up to 518. And at 518, folks, it had 148,000 contracts. Well, we come back today. We went to a lower low, even though it looks positive, with 105,000 contracts. That, I wouldn't buy it yet. I suspect this low will get tested again, meaning the 468. But you get that test with lighter volume, you're going to have some action there. And if we bring this back and put this W, let's see. I think it's going to be W1 for a continuous contract. No, WI. Oh, yeah, you know what I'll do? I'm going to put WEAT, because if you don't, if you don't trade the futures, what you want to look at is you can look at the Tecream Fund. It's an ETF. It's WEAT. Now, there's not a huge amount of volume in this, but the spread is only 2 or 3 cents, so the spread's pretty cool, meaning it's not a lot. The low in this for the year is $8.49. The high is $12.27. And what you'd want to see in this equity, when it took off last week, when the futures took off, went from $8.58 up to $9.59, then it backed down. You'd want to let this baby get into 879 to 864. That's how this would be setting up. And if we put this on a weekly, yeah, you're going to see. This is a nice setup, man, because what you also have is this. You have the high volume spike from last week, which gets you to 959. You also have a high volume swing point in this, which is 1142 to 1227. You know. And you put that together, that would be put together with the aspect that the commodity market in general is running. And where my take is on that, and that's going to have to do with this dollar wants lower price. Dollar lower price, commodities higher price. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. And, of course, tomorrow, don't miss us tomorrow, man, because we have Apple after the close tomorrow. There's going to be big action. We're going to be right back, folks.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a 2-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge for daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go to Nabil in Atlanta. Hey, Nabil, what's going on?
Hi, Tom. How are you?
I'm doing great, man. How you been?
Doing fine, thank you.
Cool, man. So, British Petroleum, huh?
Yes.
Okay, let's take a look. So, you get BP, folks. The low here is 27. The high is 43. Now, this is a kicker because this almost pays a 7.5% dividend, and they're coming out with numbers tomorrow, right? Actually,
yes.
Oh, these will be out. This will actually be out before we're opened in the morning. Yeah, because this is coming out at 0200 on the 26th, but that's going to be England time. Yeah, so this is going to be when we wake up in the morning, this will be out. So do you own this right now?
Yes, I'm in around like 28.
Yeah, okay, so he's in at 28. He's looking for the dividend also, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I think you're going to get it. You know, this is really unusual too, folks, okay? You know, depending on how long you've been listening to me, when you have something that's a 7.5% dividend and we're in a zero rate climate, you know, it's like, hold it, man, they want to cut the dividend. Now, British Petroleum, you know, of course, you know, paid huge amounts of money because of the Gulf spill, all of the above. You know, but this looks to me like, you know, when we hit that low in February, we did it with 98 million shares, and that was going to 2.3 billion. You know, so it's not like, it looks like they're going to pay it, and it looks like, you know, can we get up again to like $32? Yeah, we probably can. You probably can get up to 33, 36. It's gonna actually blow some minds if they don't cut this dividend, folks, pretty quickly. Because just think, you own oil company, it's paying 7.5%. Let me just see what Exxon's paying right now. They're not paying anywhere near that. Yeah, they're paying 3.3. You're gonna know as soon as you wake up in the morning, man. It'll be the first thing I look at.
Yeah, absolutely. Do you have time for another one quickly?
Sure.
Yeah, GPL. I sold most of it. I have like now a few shares. They're free. What's your take on it? It went up to like 164 sometimes last week. And
give me the symbol again.
Great Pentel Silver, GPL.
I'm sorry.
GPL.
Oh, Great Panther. Oh, Great Panther. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, listen, man, I'm holding Great Panther. I think it's going higher. I mean, this finished an ABC up. The ABC up, folks, it went to 164. The ABC up was 153. And, you know, can this pull back to 126? Yeah, it can, man. I mean, you know, but to me, this thing looks like it wants to go into the $2 area. And it's coming out with numbers on May 4th. You know, so what are you in it at? What price you in it at?
I was in at like 70 cents.
Okay.
I sold. I got my money back.
Okay.
So I have three shares right now. So.
Okay. Well, I think that's, you know, then just hang there until you get a deep retracement and then go from there. Where I'm going with this, Nabil, is this. Is that it took out its swing point of $1.49 last week with volume. Technically, that's saying that's set up now to make the next run up to $2.48, you know, which is the highs of September of 2012, you know, and
okay.
We'll see whether the catalyst is enough, you know, whether it's the silver market itself or whether it's going to be earnings that come out. You know, on a fundamental basis, if silver's staying at this price point, Great Panther's going to make some money, man. You know, they have no debt. You know, silver's at $17. You know, that's quite a run from where we've been. And it looks to me like silver wants to actually run up and into that $18 and $50 area. So if we take a look, yeah, let's do this. Watch this. So if we bring this back, January, February, let's see, we're in April. January, February, March. Okay, so you get a rolling. So watch how this works, folks. If I go to January 1st, so January 1st, we're at $13.80, okay? Now, if you go out 90 days, because what happens is, here, let me go out 90 days first. So then you go out 90 days, but we got up to the $15 area, $15.50, in February 8th. So February 8th, going all the way over to the end of the quarter, you're dealing between $15 and the high was $16.17. So the way that, this is pretty cool. Okay, so the way that silver and gold companies sell this silver and gold, right, is that it's a rolling 30-day average that the gold banks buy off the companies. Now, that's not a bad rolling average. I haven't done it. Do you know what I'm saying? But I can tell by looking at it, you know, that's not a bad rolling average. It's certainly much bigger than it was in the last quarter. You know, in the last quarter, folks, we were dealing from November all the way over to December, we were dealing with $15. And so if we take a look at this and we go back in, and the market's going to be looking, saying, okay, how much are you getting out of the ground? So the last quarter, he did 17.2 million. And that was an expansion from 16.8. Now, the first quarter, the number is 18.2. You know, we'll see whether they, 18.2, that's another, almost another $1 million that their projection. And, you know, we'll see whether, in fact, it's more than that. My take is that it's going to be more than that. And the reason, because this was a very fast expansion on the way up. And you will see whether they got to take advantage of it. That's what it comes down to, man. So,
okay,
man.
Thank you, Tom.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Let's go over and take a look at ESRX, Express Scripts. This just came out with numbers. This is a full-service pharmacy benefit management company. That closed at $73.72. Excuse me, folks. It's trading at $72.10. No big deal there. Let's see what they're saying. Okay, so the estimate was $1.22, they made $1.22. Revenue, $25.2 billion, they made $24.8 billion. So the revenue was just down slightly. And if we take a look at this, oh, this is how it started. This stock, man, the stock already got killed. Prior to this, the stock's not moving after hours. But this equity has already just got smoked. It went down from a price point of $94, trading at $73. It looks like it must have been a lot of January. Yeah, it looks like the last time it came out with numbers, it went from $86 to $72. And put this on a monthly for a second. Yeah, this wants to run down to $63. Don't touch this stock. $63 is kind of screaming out there that that's where it wants to go to. TCS, let's see what this is. This is the container store. This is a trade. This is was down 51 cents today, $5.83. Right now it's at $7.10, so it's up $1.25. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming back. This is another. This was an IPO that just they took everyone to the cleaners and then smoked it. We're gonna be right back, folks.
Oh. Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage, or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at tfnn.com.
Welcome back, folks. We go back over to this container store. Container store closed at $5.83. It's trading at $7.20 right now. You get a 20% short position in this equity. Numbers go like this. So their gross margin is 57.9%. Their earnings per share, the estimate was $231 million for the sales. Sales, rather, $231 million, they made $232. Earnings per share, the estimate was 20 cents, they made 20 cents. Bottom line, there's nothing behind this stock, though. You take a look at this stock, this is pretty amazing, actually. This is a one-way trip downtown, and the stock, first day out there, trade, it goes from $18 to $37. That's in November of 2013. Goes up to $47 and then just goes straight down to $4.02. Yep, it went an IPO October the 31st at $18. Man, you talk about toasted and roasted. That's about as intense as you can get. There's no doubt about that. You know what is going to get intriguing here is, and this is... this is quite a story, too, about the aspect of, you know, robotic cars, autonomous cars, and equipment in general. And there's quite a story out there about ports and in California. So California, between L.A., check this number out, between L.A. and Long Beach, that takes in 40% of the containers that come across this country. And, you know, what has happened over the course of the years now is that longshoremen, little by little by little, have been getting put out of business. You know, and it's pretty cool because growing up in South Boston, there was a lot of longshoremen. Bottom line, we used to get hired as, they call them scallywags, and it was a huge amount of money, huge amount of work too, but huge amount of money. And so over the course of the years, those jobs have been eliminated. If you had a card or still have a card, you still make a fortune down there. That'll keep changing throughout the years. But the story that's out there is pretty amazing because autonomously, what they're doing now is that they're changing the way containers come off, the way containers actually get pushed out of the yard. And it's going to end up going from using motorized, meaning gasoline vehicles in order to do that, to electric vehicles doing that. And it's a lot easier, of course. It's not like you and I using an electric vehicle on the expressway. This would be using electric vehicles as a robot, taking goods off, and then getting them to, not necessarily the destination, but getting them off the boat, onto other trucks that will take them out of there. So things are gonna go quick in that whole area. It's pretty amazing. And that in itself, and I'm gonna go from here right to the Saudis. They're gonna be selling 5% of Amoco, which is going to be the largest IPO ever. And they're thinking it's going to be $2 trillion, folks. Yeah, they're driverless trucks. $2 trillion for only that 5%. What that says to me is that oil is going to stay lower for a longer period of time. Because when you own the gold, folks, okay, and Saudi has owned the gold forever, you don't sell it. The bottom line is you don't sell it. When you think that it may go down or things may change, guess what? Why not sell it? You know, because that's where I think that whole thing is going. So it's going to be wild watching the whole thing shake out. And it won't be hard with the amount of oil that we have now in this country and the aspect of how much is turning electric. You know, it won't be hard to basically keep that price down. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night. Have a safe night. Tomorrow, big action, folks. Apple's coming out with numbers. Go get them, folks.